Hi, my name is Kristy Jansen, Assistant Professor in Finance and Business Economics at USC Marshall. Why do we care about understanding the role of teams in potentially alleviating or exacerbating behavioral biases that are common at the individual level? Organizations around the world entrust teams with a large variety of tasks, ranging from setting a country's monetary policy to designing corporate governance to making asset management decisions. Despite the central role of teams in many areas of decision making, we still know little about the way in which they influence the quality of decisions. Whether teams attenuate or exacerbate behavioral biases is an open empirical question. Therefore, to what extent biases at the individual level survive within a team? To study the effect of teams on the use of behavioral biases, we analyze managers' traits in the mutual fund industry. The goal of asset managers in this industry is to make investment decisions on behalf of their clients in order to increase clients' wealth. The mutual fund industry is useful in analyzing the effect of teams on decision-making for three main reasons. First, the problem that asset managers confront is a classical example of judgment under uncertainty, namely picking stocks, an area of decision-making where behavioral biases are known to be very common at the individual level. Second, the adoption of teams in the asset management industry has grown substantially over time. And third, the mutual fund industry allows us to observe managers who operate within a team, but also when the same managers of the team operate individually. This feature is important because we circumvent the problem that managers who manage in teams are fundamentally different from managers who operate alone. In other words, any result we find can be attributed more convincingly to the effect of teams as organizational structure, rather than systematic differences in characteristics between managers in solo versus team-managed funds. To study how mutual fund teams respond to their members' biases, we focus on the extrapolation bias. The extrapolation bias occurs when investors expect higher future stock returns after high past returns of those stocks. Investors have these expectations despite the weak empirical evidence of correlation in recent and future stock returns. Unfortunately, we do not have access to managers' expectations about future stock returns, so we cannot directly measure their extrapolative behavior. Instead, we are backing out their expectations by analyzing managers' traits. If managers move towards stocks that have done well in the recent past, but move away from stocks that have recently performed poorly, we classify those managers as extrapolators. Around 46% of our sample is characterized as extrapolative, whereas 54% is not. We refer to them as contrarians. To answer our main research question, whether teams alleviate or exacerbate biases, we proceed as follows. First, we ask whether extrapolation as we measure it from the data is indeed consistent with a bias in investor behavior. Second, we ask whether individual-level extrapolation is transmitted to teams, which is really the central part of our study. Third, we ask why is it that extrapolation is different within teams. First, we found that return extrapolation leads to worse investment outcomes from the manager's perspective. For instance, extrapolators achieve worse future returns as opposed to contrarians. This finding is consistent with a host of different ways to measure performance, such as benchmark-adjusted returns or CAPM alphas. Moreover, extrapolators are less likely to become top performers within their style category, and they receive less inflows, and hence their funds grow less. This evidence suggests that extrapolation has a systematic negative effect on managers' compensation and career. To study the effect of teams on return extrapolation, we select a sample of team-managed funds whose members have all, at some point in time during their career, managed a fund by themselves. This setup ensures that differences in the performance of teams versus individuals are not driven by differences in skill. Then, we compare extrapolation among individual managers with their extrapolative behavior in a team. We show that in teams whose managers on average extrapolate at the individual level, this tendency is reduced by about 80% once they join the team. To understand why teams attend away behavioral biases, we are going to rely on insights from psychology and economics. These insights suggest that two mechanisms are at play. The first one is the internal reflection hypothesis. This hypothesis suggests that because members of the team have to communicate their views, their thinking process, and their decisions with others, each member of the team engages in deeper cognitive reflection. In other words, they think more carefully about the decisions they are making and are therefore less subjected to biases. The second hypothesis is called the external reflection hypothesis. In this case, it's not the members themselves who become aware of their own biases, but it's other team members who point out the mistake of their peers. We test for both these mechanisms and find evidence in favor of the internal reflection hypothesis. So in sum, we found that teams play an important role in reducing the effects of behavioral biases on trading behavior and investment performance. The results in the study therefore shed new light on the benefit of team-based asset management.